你的艺术道路在不断延展的过程中，你越来越觉得你力有所不能，不是你觉得你越来本事越大，你面对比如说咱们我们的文化，就包括中国画，越学我们越觉得我们能一生能做的实际上很有限。我在这儿开始啊。 我面对自然，面对生活，包括把一些感受的东西，记在心里边，经过积淀、积累，它在自己的内心发酵，把不同情境下、不同时间所看到的东西、所思所感，都集中在自己的内心里边。当我要画一张画的时候，这种积累，是吧，就很自然地吐露出来。
Jia Guangjian is a Chinese ink and wash artist who has been amazing viewers with his exquisite paintings. In 1992, his Silent Autumn was greeted with great acclaim after being put on show at the National Gallery of China in Beijing, promising a bright future for the young artist. Since then, his career has gone from strength to strength, with his work being praised for bringing a so-called boneless style of technique back into contemporary Chinese painting. In 2019, he was nominated as the president of the Tianjin Academy of Fine Arts. Jia was born in the rural area of Yongqing County in the northern province of Hebei. His grandfather was a folk craftsman who made colorful toys out of clay that Jia says have been a big influence on his art. As a child, he showed an artistic bent from an early age. When other children were playing outside, Jia preferred to be alone, especially in his grandmother's small peach orchard, watching blossoms bloom and fall.
这里边唯独整个一个小桃园，这里边唯独有一棵杏花。我曾经在一篇文章里边写到这个，就是说这棵杏花从来每年开一大树的杏花，特别的漂亮。然后，但是它不长一个杏子，它只开花不结果那棵树。过去这种童年的记忆，哎呀，这杏花很美，我就尝试着用墨骨的方式去表达它。所以说我最早的几幅墨骨的画像画绘都是画的杏花。 这种感觉，是吧？嗯，啊，你看这块儿，是吧？按照这规律，你看都是这样的，都是这样的，是吧？这些弧线，现在什么需要什么呢？它需要这个东西，是吧？你看它舒服了，整个构图舒服了，但就它这一笔。 把这几个空间分割出来，它就更有意思，是吧？所以画面看什么呢？是吧？它不是看它品味一幅画的，不是看它画的真实不真实，也不是单纯的看笔墨，它就是一个综合的一些东西。你说我记得上大学的那时候，我不知道你们有没有这种体会，是吧？这对我感觉就是最重要的、最大的难点，就是构图，啊。 那时候就天天，我记得坐在公共汽车上都想着构图，然后怎么构，就是构图的规律啊，都在想。
Jia says his artistic path began out of pure interest in his childhood. Graduating from secondary school in 1984, he was assigned to work as an assistant teacher in Hebei Institute of Technology. But living with a stable job and salary, he felt his dream of being an artist was slipping away. So he decided to spend his spare time after work every day learning painting, in the hope of being admitted to the Tianjin Academy of Fine Arts, which was then one of China's top 8 fine arts colleges. After 3 years of hard work and perseverance, he finally made it into his dream college in 1987.
当时在工学院的时候，我就是每个周日就是去一个地方，那就是去天津的那个滨江道。滨江道有一个美术书店，或者到一些这个文具店去看一些画材啊，或者什么的。要不就到一些画店去看画，好像那就是生活的全部，就那么多。他这种专注的一个心态，就是他非常虔诚，没有任何的功利心，就是他吸引你。我越来越感觉到，就像推开半扇门，从这个门缝里看到一个非常新奇的、神秘的一个世界。那就是中国画。上研究生的时候，那时候经常泡在这个北京公园，泡那里边后边有个花房，那些花工啊什么都在那儿。那里边长了很多的那个像这个月季啊，那月季是没人剪裁的，没人剪的，都是野的，在那儿长很大，也没人管它。哎，就能看到，哎呦，这月季还能是长成这样。带个面包，在那中午一睡，一躺累了就在那一靠，人花了很长时间在那儿。哎。
Jia has always felt awe and respect for traditional Chinese painting, a feeling that comes from his experiences as a student.
最大的触动是什么呢？过去你想，我们学过素描，是吧？学过速写。还画画人物，包括人体写生这个什么，全画过。你画几片叶子，你还画不过宋人吗？当时呀就觉得，我回头画像宋人那样精到的，画几张工笔，一画你就知道了，是不是那么回事儿？哎，他就是这是中国画的，他观察方法，包括认识方法，他不一样。你这样慢慢才知道，哎。不是有了基本造型，能不是你就一下就达到了。
Over 28 years, Jia has been searching for and finding his own voice in Chinese ink and wash painting. Just like when he was a young man, he has always been thinking about how to use his paintbrush to convey the world in his heart.
我画的那幅《秋来无声》那幅画，实际上是我第一幅工笔画的一个。创造它是一个转变，这种转变它需要一段时间的沉淀和积累，这都不是一挥而就的，是抽筋断骨式的，是很痛苦的，是吧？然后最后出现一个境界，这还是就是说高度的精神激动，高度的专注。
After 1992,Jia Guangjian's creativity reached its peak. With Early Morning by a Cold River in 1994, Green Cover from the Wind in 1996, The Sound of Autumn in 2000, and Flowers with a Light Scent in 2003, his style has matured. His accumulated experience has been a source of inspiration for him, leading to more and more output.During his research into ancient Chinese painting, he discovered that a traditional Chinese style of painting, the boneless style, was almost lost in contemporary art. Without any outlines, the boneless style created forms through washes of ink instead of sketching. This painting, which measures 2.2 meters high and 2 meters wide, is the largest boneless painting he has created. The application of boneless technique adds a layer of softness to it, and it is well balanced with every aspect covered. Finding one's own style within an existing artistic framework is, in fact, a goal that many artists spend their lives pursuing.
它是运用一种水墨画创作的一种思维方式，就是说我想到哪儿画到哪儿，这种灵感就是不期而遇，它不是理性的，它是完全是感性的。荷叶实际上运用了墨骨的技法，同时又融入了一些山水画的一些皴染的技法，而且是几次完成。
这种方式实际上也是技法上的一个创新。你不断的在消化传统，不断的在积累生活，不断的在被生活的很多东西所感动，你觉得越来越感觉画画是特别美的一件事，特别好的一件事。 而且特别轻松的一件事，对我来说，比如说工作的这种紧张啊，包括工作的也有很多的压力啊，包括这些东西，都可以。你拿起画笔的时候，真正专注于创作的时候，这个时候，其他任何的东西都会烟消云散。
In 2012, an art park rose from the ground. This art park, located among fields in Yongqing County in Hebei Province, did not choose the bustling city as its foothold, but hoped to bring art into the countryside so that more villagers could have access to the best art.
很小的时候，当时在农村，我们在那个年代看到的东西非常少。我在一本书里看到了飞天的形象。 很厚的一本词典里边一个插图，那在几岁的小孩看到这个形象，这人怎么还能飞起来呀？你不明白，就感觉这个呀，一下就打开了一个一种梦想。还记得那时候，哎，有时候做梦就梦到，我看到以后，我到现在也忘不了那种感觉，那种新鲜感，一直到现在，我觉得都在我脑子里边都非常鲜活的这个形象。 那也许，有的人，是吧？有的孩子，也许就因为他在艺术院，哎，我看到了一个什么什么样的画，也像我一样，哎，他在一直在脑子里缭绕，那他就去追寻这种梦想，哎，将来他也可能走上一条艺术的一个道路。
过去我跟一个作家，过去这个老师，很小的时候，20多岁的时候，他就说的话，我们当时都似懂非懂。我们20多岁哪知道是人生的苦是什么呢？没有苦，到你等于走过来了以后，那么你才知道绘画是什么样子，画和人，是吧？人生和艺术。 过去是两趟线，越走走走走，变成了一条道，对吗？你的画就是人生，你人生就是画。你说，哎，我达到了什么样的境界？那还远着呢，对吗？人用一生的心血能达到一个什么样的一个境界？用李克冉的话说，就是你传统僧砖添瓦，你僧一块砖，你添一块瓦。 就很了不起了，是吧？而且水仙能现在就能长那么高啊？哎，啊，冬天开花，是吧？嗯，哦，挺好。
For the memory of apricot blossoms, the painting career of Jia Guangjian started with the inspiration that led to desire, a desire for art. He observed greedily, accumulated life experiences. and mastered the skills of Chinese painting to find his own voice. These days, he is also trying to pass on his skills and wisdom to a new generation of artists.
就是说这些轮廓的处理呀，是吧？它是按照中国画的官场方法一种理念来造型，它不是像西画那样的，是吧？这个感觉好，正好就说这个，它这个火候啊，它就自然出来的。你看这样，它不都多生动啊？感觉，是吧？啊。